What's your best? We never speak of this moment ever again. In high school, a friend and I were eating at an Italian restaurant at a table around the corner from both of our parents. We were splitting a pizza and pitcher of root beer. As we were finishing up, a woman comes to our table and tells us how proud she is of us, that we were so comfortable being open about our relationship, and that she paid for our meal. There we were, two straight guys staring at each other, while mentally balancing the pros and cons of food vs sexual preference. We took the meal, and went and sat with our parents. Never before have two straight men been so conflicted, but one must never turn down free food. So back in high school, in my Spanish class, there was a girl who sat behind me, and loved to put her feet against the back of my chair and push. It was annoying for me, so I would always turn around and slap her legs, so she could drop her feet. She would do it so much, that I got into the habit of just slapping her legs without even turning. So one day I feel her feet on the back of my chair as usual, so I throw a slap without looking. Her legs felt oddly soft, but I thought I was just imagining things. Still, her feet are up against my chair, so I throw an even harder slap. It's soft. I turn around. I had slapped my Spanish teacher's ass twice. Middle school. I've decided it never happened. Let me preface this comment by letting you know that my dad died when I was about 14, as that fact contributes to my story. So my boyfriend and I were recently having sex, and I noticed he smells different. He's not wearing his usual deodorant slash cologne, but I can't place the scent. We're laying there naked afterward, all covered in sweat, and it dawns on me. I blurt out, "You smell like my dad," and burst into tears. My boyfriend gets the deer in headlights look, and awkwardly tries to comfort me as I cry about how post-coitus he smells like my dead father. Never talked about that moment again. One night when drinking, my male friend and I, male as well, stayed at a friend's apartment, because we got way too drunk to drive. Our options were the floor or a lover seat. We fought over the lover seat before finally agreeing that we would share it. We cuddled. It was weird in the morning. Me and my buddy once in high school were getting blowjobs from one girl at the same time. I remember we accidentally touched hands during this, and then locked eyes for a second. High school is a weird time. I believe we came to an unspoken understanding there. One night me, my blood cousin, my cousin who was not blood, but merely the son of a good friend of my mom's, his girlfriend, and a good girl, space, friend of mine were on our way to having a fun-filled, ecstasy-fueled night of wonder and magic. We stop by my non-blood cousin's house to pop our pills, and we kind of hang around until his girlfriend gets ready, showers, and we can dip. So me, my real cousin, and my other friend are laying in his bed bullshitting, waiting, and out of nowhere, the bed feels painfully comfortable. We all talk for a straight 10 minutes of how comfortable this bed is, and how we should bring it with us every time we party. So at this point, my fake cousin bursts into the room in his underwear and announces, and I quote, "Time to fucking rip those pants off my babies. This is now an underwear party." So we oblige, we turn on all of our party lights, we turn up the music, and there's the four of us, half naked, rolling around the bed giving each other massages reeking of baby oil and Vicks vapor rub. We tell a lot of stories from back in those days, but we don't tell that one no more. I peed myself on my friend's bed once out of nowhere. I realized it, and just went back to sleep, because I didn't know what to do. When we both woke up again, it had dried, and she casually told me that the stain on that bed was from when she went to bed with her hair wet. But it was on my side, and hadn't been there before. I don't know if I peed so much she thought she did it, or was doing me a favor by coming up with that bullshit excuse, even though I didn't say I thought it was bullshit, or she wasn't washing her hair correctly. But it was me. I checked my panties, it was me, and I'm so sorry. When my newly, as in, 2 days earlier, adopted brothers of age about 4 or 5 started getting pornographic with me during bath time, after mom undressed us, the brothers were taken away the next day. My parents never spoke of it, to ask if I remembered, and I never brought it up again. I was too young to know what was wrong. It was weird, when I was in my 20s, and rediscovered the memory in my head. It was like reopening a box that has been in your attic forever, and technically you've always known what was in it, but when you look at the contents again after so much time with such a radically different perspective, you're like, what the fuck is this doing here? This is going to be NSFW, fair warning. Years ago, three of my friends and I were spending an afternoon in my basement. At the moment, we had the television off and were only on my laptop. This was back when chat roulette was a big thing, so we were on there just messing around. Suddenly, we get an interesting chat partner. A beautiful young woman who appears to be fingering herself off camera. She sees that there are four of us, all male, and just says, "Sup guys." We exchange looks of, "Oh man, this looks promising." Within a minute or two, we get her to show us her tits. Then she asks us if we want her to do more stuff, i.e. dildos or w/e, but says she wants to see us one on one. My friend Chris spreads his hands out and goes, "Guys, I got this." So, we all think, fuck it, why not, get up and go to the other section of my basement, where you can hear what's going on, but not see anything. We hear Chris chuckle a couple times, and one time he goes, "Oh my god," and laughs a little bit. Then it goes silent. This repeats for my two other friends. Then it's my turn. I was playing good host and letting them go first. I get to the computer, and this chick is naked on the floor with a hairbrush handle in her vagina. I shit you not. Right when I walk over, she's already going at it. So, I do the polite thing, take my shirt off, and start masturbating furiously. It was interesting. She bent over and all that good stuff, and after some time I was finished. I told my friends to come back over. Our lovely partner in crime got dressed and sent us the message, "See you boys around," and disconnected. We all looked at each other, laughed a little bit, and agreed never to tell anyone of this event. No particular reason, we just felt that no one needed to know that we technically listened to each other jerk it with some chick on chat roulette one at a time. Everyone was silent. Thankfully, I didn't have to listen to anyone masturbate. But, yeah, that's my favorite story. We agreed to never tell anyone. No throwaway, I jaff at this point. Last year I was in my basement with a girl I knew, on the couch fooling around and watching TV. Well, apparently my stepsister came home and decided to come downstairs. She knocked on the door and walked slowly to the stairs because she knew I had a girl over, but I couldn't hear her due to the fact that my ears were completely covered by this girl's inner thighs. All of a sudden we both see her foot appear at the top of the stairs, so I jump up onto the couch and try desperately to put on my pants while the girl literally dives behind the couch trying to hide. My stepsister just stood there for a second, then said, "I just wanted my phone charger." I couldn't look her in the eye for about a month. The worst part was that we all had dinner together after that, like my whole family and this girl. Awkward as fuck. I was in Vegas with my boys, and I got trashed early. I somehow ended up in my room, and during the night I went into the bathroom and fell in the tub and split my forearm open. I just went back to sleep. I wake up to blood all over the white sheets and carpet. At that moment a cleaning lady comes in and sees me covered in blood naked. The look in her eyes still haunt me today. I just grabbed my wallet, threw her a 50 and she left. I could have gotten away with murder in Vegas. In college I ended up coming home from the bar one night with one of my ex-girlfriends. Naturally we start having sex. A couple of minutes in I realize that there is a problem which I somehow didn't notice before we started. I really have to pee. Drunk brain says, "Don't worry about it, just keep going." Bladder says, "You will not ignore me. I must deal with this problem, but stopping mid-coitus is clearly not an option." Drunk brain points out that I'm wearing a condom which is, after all, designed to contain liquid. I decide that my best course of action is to just pee a little bit to relieve the pressure until I can finish. Silly drunk man. Everyone knows that you can't just pee a little bit. So I start peeing inside her and cannot stop. I think for a split second that maybe she won't notice, and then I'm like, "You're gonna pee like a gallon, she will notice." Only one option, escape. She's facing away from me so maybe I can get out of the room before she sees what I've done. I pull out and waddle out of the room with this ever expanding, urine filled balloon of a condom swinging off my dick between my knees. It turns out condoms hold a lot of liquid. This thing was like a huge ass water balloon. I got to the bathroom and tried to slip it off, at which point it immediately exploded, covering me and the entire bathroom in pee. I say, fuck it, I'll deal with this later, go back to the room and pretend to pass out. I wake up to an accusing glare. I know what you did inside me last night. Turns out she cleaned up all my pee in the bathroom after I passed out. We never speak of it again, but we both remember. She cannot forget the shame. I cannot forget how fucking funny it was and how damn good that pee felt. Damn, I've got a great one, but it'll probably get buried all the way down in the thread. In high school, I spent the night at my friend's house. We are both male. We hung out in his garage drinking rum, reading comic books, and talking girls slash life, etc. Both of us getting pretty hammered as the night went on. Being drunk at that age tended to make me incredibly horny, and it tended to make my friend incredibly tired. He was in high school and worked two jobs as well, so he was almost always sleepy anyway when I'd hang out with him. We decided it was getting late and time to go to bed. He let me take the couch in his basement while he went up to his bedroom to crash. This was the usual arrangement when I'd stay over. So there I am, on the couch, room spinning, boner throbbing. One thing I knew is that his dad, who'd passed away some years before, had a stash of Playboys in a closet down there in the basement. So it's 4 a.m. and I drunkenly decide that it's fap time to some 70s Bush and torpedo tits. I grab a stack of 6 or 7 issues and start flipping through them. And I get to doing what comes naturally, of course, making the bald man throw up. The problem is that I'm really too drunk to get a good rhythm going, and I end up passing out right there. Pants down, cock in hand, Playboys strewn about. The next morning, I wake up. It took me a few minutes to realize it, but several things were immediately apparent to me. I was fully dressed, under a blanket I know I didn't pull from anywhere, and, most distressingly, all of the Playboys were back in the closet, stacked neatly exactly where they'd been before. I head upstairs and my friend is at the breakfast table eating pancakes. His mom's cooking, and she politely offers me breakfast. I say sure, and then I glance at my friend. I quietly ask him, "Hey man, did you come down to check on me or anything last night?" "Haha, I kinda passed out, I just wasn't sure if you woke me up at any time, or what?" He looks at me a little strange and then says, "No, I went right upstairs and passed out too." "Why?" "No reason," I reply. I believed him too. If he'd walked in on me mid-wank and asleep, he'd have let me know. At the very least, he'd be laughing his ass off at this attempt at morning conversation. My friend's siblings were all older and off at college at this time. It was just him and his mother living there. My friend remained clueless, and nothing relating to the night's events was ever brought up by me or her. I was in a perpetual state of cringe YWTF any time I ever had to interact with her after that, though. TL, doctor passed out masturbating at my friend's house. His mother was totally classy and cool about finding me in a state of undress. Not sure if it is true, a kind of a friend story, but here it goes. Two guys my host brother knew in Germany went for a long weekend in Spain, basically to get shit-faced in a warmer climate. On their last night they were staying in a little town on the coast before heading back. This town had a zoo, nothing special, but all they remember is going in, jumping a fence, and seeing some turtles. They felt bad for the little guys, grabbed them, and escaped with them, throwing them into the sea off a cliff to freedom. The next day when flying home, nursing a hangover, they grabbed the local newspaper to read. One of the first articles could be summed up as, "To land tortoises found dead washed up on the shore, after being stolen from the zoo." The two guys looked at each other and realized they had thrown two fully grown tortoises off a cliff into deep salt water, thinking they were turtles and could survive. Obviously though, they did speak of it. First time me and my best friend smoked pot, we did way too much, and we were just laying down on the couch and the feeling of touching each other was just magnified to the poor nullable. My knee kept hitting her girl thing, and I was breathing on her neck. We suddenly realized where that was going. I jokingly yelled "gay" and went to pee, then made a pillow fort between us. I have this friend who is a girl. I'm also a girl. She is very affectionate physically, but has made it clear she is not attracted to me. I used to be attracted to her. One day we were hugging. My arms were around her waist. She is a lot smaller than I am. I literally reached down and grabbed her ass with purpose. I don't know what is going on in my mind. We both still get quite flustered when we think of it. No throwaway because fuck it. We were in maybe third grade. It was a friend's birthday party, and being the rebellious kids we had stayed up late. After a few prank calls and other stuff, we somehow, I honestly cannot remember whose idea it was, got the idea to lay on our backs, hold our legs up, and show each other our buttholes. There was nothing sexual about it, but we got one hell of a kick from doing it. Why? I still cannot explain. I just remember us passing around a flashlight as the four inspected the one's anus and so on. I even think we waited and watched for one of my friends to fart, just to see what it looked like. Looking back on it, I don't feel guilty, just very scared at how creepy we were. So far all of my friends remember the whole ordeal, and made a pact to never speak of it, unless it is just amongst ourselves. I ran out of condoms before intercourse one time, and decided to go to my roommate's room to get one from his stash. As I opened the door and making way to his drawer, I noticed out of the corner of my eye that he and his girlfriend were naked and in complete shock. Then he asked me what the hell I was doing in his room. IUHH. Need a rubber. Then he threw his dirty one at me, missed, and told me to get the hell out. TLDR. Needed rubber to bone, went in roommate's room while he was boning. Didn't bone. I once hooked up with this girl in a leaky bathtub. The bathroom was very small, and there were no lights at all. Also, a golden retriever was there with us in the bathtub. I never talked to the girl after the incident. I see her in my city from time to time. Never to be spoken of again. Last year on 4th of July, me and my GF just wanted to stay in and drink. We started watch Star Wars V and I don't know what possessed me to go on a tequila drinking binge. I fucking blacked out, but remember patches of that night. When I woke up the next day, my GF told me what had happened. She said my stomach started hurting, and I told her I needed to take a shit. I went to the bathroom and started taking a massive dump, but then yelled to her saying I was gonna throw up. She brought me the trash can, and I fucking threw up and took a massive dump right in front of her at the same fucking time. We told each other we wouldn't tell anybody. You bet your sweet ass she told her friends. TL, Dr. I shitted and threw up at the same time in front of my GF.